You just can't be mad at it. I'm breaking out and I'm looking dull, but look, I'm revived again. Hey, baby loves, welcome back to the Fiesta. If you're new here, my name is Keyshawna Dupuy, and if you're not, you're loyal. Don't forget to subscribe and click the notification bell below if you're interested in seeing more hair or skin, product reviews, tips, tricks, and advice. Today, we are doing a turmeric mask. We're actually gonna do two turmeric masks. Since I did my top non-steroidal eczema reduction flare-up products, which included turmeric, I've gotten a few questions regarding what my favorite mask is, if I recommend any, so I figured let me just do them. If you're interested, I'm gonna go ahead and link the video above and below so that you can check it out after this one. So a little bit about turmeric. I already spoke about it in my eczema video I just mentioned, but the main reason I use turmeric is for its brightening properties and its healing properties. It's amazing overall. If you wanna know more about it, definitely go check that video out. Something I wanna remind everyone before we continue. Turmeric can slow down hair growth, so make sure that you avoid your eyebrows or just anywhere you don't want hair loss. Don't use it there. Also, it can leave a yellowish tint on your skin. So put on an old t-shirt, some pajamas, you don't care. Don't put on white. Make sure there's no white sheets on your bed because we're gonna do a body mask and a face mask. And we just wanna avoid messing up our good stuff. The first thing I wanna go over is our ingredient. The first mask is going to be a eczema body mask. You can use it anywhere in your body, including your face. So of course you'll be needing turmeric. You'll be needing plain yogurt. I personally use Greek yogurt and honey. This is Linden raw honey. As well as your mixing bowl and mixing utensils. If all you have is a spoon and a bowl, do your thing, because that's what I'd be using if I didn't see this on Amazon and lost track. Then we're also going to do a acne mask. So for that, you'll be needing turmeric, raw honey, and apple cider vinegar. This is optional. Then some type of milk, face oil, moisturizer, shea butter, something along those lines. I personally have my shea butter here. Okay, so unfortunately for me, the weather is changing and it's about to be winter soon. So my skin has started breaking out, flaring up. It has not been fun. So I'm actually excited to do these masks about that time. My skin has been looking dull on top of breaking out, so it's time, okay? I have already went ahead and cleansed my skin, patted it dry with a fresh paper towel, which is obviously wet now. When I do my full night routine is when I would do a mask like this for my face, but when I do my turmeric mask, I usually don't exfoliate, so that is completely up to you as you figure out what your skin likes. The first thing we're gonna do is actually the eczema mask, because I like to leave that on just a bit longer than the face one. So let's start with that one first. Take your mixing bowl, and I do equal parts of turmeric and honey. Things to know about the honey. This is Linden honey. It's a good alternative to Manuka honey. Manuka honey is the preferred honey when making any of your DIY masks, simply because it's raw and it's unpasteurized, which means that it has the most potential for a topical application. Pasteurized is like a process they use on honey and milk. It's meant to make the shelf life longer, which is obviously not something we care about when it comes to our skin. We rather anything is gonna be better for us. But Manuka honey is expensive. Linden honey is a little cheaper. I got this one for $8, still expensive versus $3 for some pure honey. Use what you have because any honey is better than none, but always try to go for raw when it comes to your skin. But honey overall has some great benefits. It's used for acne prevention, eczema. It speeds up the healing process of your skin cells. It reduces inflammation. It's a natural exfoliator. It brightens dark spots. And it can actually help reduce the production of candida. I can never say that word. AKA yeast, which ladies. So just make sure that your skin does not have a sensitivity to honey or anything that's related to honey. If you got one of these from Amazon like I did, I'm using the biggest scooper. I personally just mix and go. I don't use actual measurements. Also, when I make things, I usually just use a tablespoon as my safety net. And again, mix as I go. So followed up by the plain yogurt. Plain yogurt also has a lot of properties that we just love. I'm putting a little more yogurt. I like mine creamy for my body. Let's talk about these benefits though. Plain yogurt actually has lactic acid, which is known to help dissolve dead skin cells and tighten your pores. A lot of the benefits include added moisture, brightened skin, evens out your skin tone, so hyperpigmentation, anything like that, UV protection, eczema, smooth acne, help prevent future breakouts, and it actually is really good for digestive health and lady health. So this is what it looks like all in the bowl. And then we mixy. Little golden color of turmeric is so pretty. All right, so this is the before of my skin. Probably go down here as well. Here's my face. Let's get started. Gonna apply it straight onto the skin. So here's the thing, with the face mask, you wanna apply it onto freshly cleansed skin. With the body one, I don't like to simply because it's a lot more work and it still works the same to me. Versus cleansing, putting this on, and then going back in the shower, take it all off. I usually just don't cleanse beforehand. I do a pretty light layer. I don't go too thick. With that being said, this would be enough. One scoop of each thing would be enough for my entire body. I really focus on my target areas and try to get it to a pretty thin layer on my skin. When my skin's doing really well and then it's only just certain places that's reacting, I put it specifically only on those places. Ladies, wear gloves, use brushes, utensils, stuff like that when applying because it will stain your nails. We're gonna do the face mask now. So as I mentioned before, the apple cider vinegar is optional. Apple cider vinegar in this case will be used as a toner in between you cleansing your face and the mask. You do not have to use it. I personally love using apple cider vinegar as a toner. I would dilute the apple cider vinegar with some water in a little spray bottle, put it on a cotton round pad, and then put it on. But it has a lot of benefits when used on skin due to its anti-inflammatory property. It can exfoliate the skin, absorb excess oil, unblock clogged pores, and it's a whole bunch of other things. So like I said, I really liked using it. It helped a lot with the brightening of the skin and reducing acne scar, black, dark spots, anything like that. I really think it's great. You're gonna grab a cotton pad and then just do not press too hard. I'm gonna do a light pass with this. Don't forget your neck. Do research, see how you feel about it. But again, that was optional. Okay, so for this, we're literally gonna just do even parts of the honey and turmeric. For this part, I'm going to use my medium sized one. If you don't want to waste your turmeric and honey but you're making the eczema mask, if you're not sure how your face will react to the yogurt or anything like that, and you don't want to use that complete one, mix the turmeric and honey first, put that on your face, and then add yogurt and continue on to your body. This is the consistency in which I like my face mask. Still dripping, still soft. And then we just apply directly. I do a pretty thin layer. It's really smooth going onto the skin. It's sticky due to the honey, so beware that. Definitely avoid your baby hairs, boo, because like I said, hair loss. Personally, I have eczema on my neck, so I'm gonna go back to the body mask and use that for the bottom part of my face instead of this acne one. I don't break out on my neck area. I just get flare-ups. Okay, so here we are. I think you can actually see the difference in the face mask versus the body mask. This is a lot lighter. It's a lot thinner, spreads a lot more. The yogurt really stretches the turmeric and honey versus this. This is stickier, it's thicker. It's grainier, but it does not hurt the skin at all. No scrubbing feeling. Had this on for about 5 minutes now. This is how it looks as it starts to dry. I usually try to stick between 10 to 20 minutes, no longer. If this burns at all, take it off. It should not be burning. Okay. Oh, before I turn off the vent, here I am. A look. Okay, so it's been 10 minutes. My tester for my body is usually just patting it and it doesn't lift off. Lady, like honestly y'all, use gloves if you don't want to have a tint. If you have your nails done, definitely use gloves or just avoid using this for a little bit because it does stain everything. It'll come out pretty soon, but it stains everything. This is why you put on old t-shirts, because I got it on my shirt by accident. Okay, so when washing off your skin, if you're gonna use a rag or anything like that, use a dark one because it will stain that as well. Obviously I'm not about to take a shower, but with my body, want to just hop in the shower and try to be as targeted as possible when taking it off, because it will also stain. If you have a white tub and sink like I do, it will stain that as well. So just be careful. It comes out, don't get me wrong, it's a temporary stain. It will come out within a day, few hours, anything like that, depending on when you spray on it. It will come out. I'm just letting you know, it does stain. It gets a little messy. I'm gonna turn on the vent so you can really see. Here's my skin. So you can really get a close up of my yellow tint. It's okay. I think the best glow with this mask happens the next day or two. You literally, your skin just starts to glow so nicely, looks awakened. Now we just continue with your regular skin routine. In my case, shea butter for my body. And if you see my night routine after I did my mask, everything I continued with after that. I'm gonna go ahead and put on some niacinamide, retinol, put on my aloe vera. And then here's a tip, if you're having any type of eczema flare-ups or when my dark spots get pretty bad, I actually just go straight for my shea raw butter as well. It's really good for my skin, it does not irritate me. So that's what I'm about to do, and I'm gonna show y'all my glow. 1 second. Here's my skin after applying my products and my shea butter. You just can't be mad at it. I'm breaking out and I'm looking dull, but look, I'm revived again. Here's my skin after being moisturized. Please let me know if you give these masks a try. I really hope they work for you the way they work for me. I absolutely love them. I already know that in a day or two, this glow is gonna be serious. If you made it this far, I hope you already liked and subscribed. If you have any video suggestions or requests, put them in the comment box below or DM me on Instagram. And if your idea is selected, you will get a shout out. Thank you so much for watching. I'll be back soon. Ciao.